Dear friends, good evening. In this short video, I will finish the second declension by speaking about neuter nouns. As I told in the first lessons, in the first videos, neuter nouns are not masculine and feminine. It is another gender because in Latin there are three genders, not only masculine and feminine, but also neuter nouns. And in particular, for the second declension, all the neuter nouns have as main character the fact that the nominative singular ends in -um. So last time we saw the first two groups. In the first group we have masculine and few female nouns in which nominative singular ends in -us. Then we saw second group of nouns in which the nominative ends in -er or -ir. And now instead we see neuter nouns ending in e nominative singular. In particular, in this situation, the declension is a bit different because, first of all, I have to say that the genitive singular is always, as usual, is ends up in he because we are talking about second declension. So all the nouns of the second declension have this character, have genitive singular in e. But however, the neuter nouns, and this is an aspect that you should memorize very well because also when we will see neuter nouns belong to the third declension, the rule will be always the same. All the neuter nouns in Latin have the direct cases that are the same, that are actually for the singular and for the plural, of course. What do I mean? Well, I mean that first of all, direct case are nominative, accusative, and vocative. For the singular, all the neuter nouns of the second declension ends in -um. And for the plural, instead, they end up in -a. To understand better what I say, what I'm saying, I advise you to have a look at the description of the video in which I put the declension of a word, which is actually bellum belli, which actually means the war. As you can see, we have for the singular nominative bellum, genitive belli, as usual, as we said, dative bello, the ending in o for the dative singular is the same as mundus and also as puer and also as vir. Look at now, accusative and vocative have the same ending in so bellum and bellum. Not, for example, bellum or belle, right? The same. And then ablative, bello. Also, the ablative is the same for all the nouns belonging to the second declension. Mundus, puer, vir. Let's go to plural. As you can see, we have nominative, accusative, and vocative that ends up in a. So their inflection is a. Bella for the nominative. Genitive is bellorum, as puerorum, as virorum, as mundorum, so is all the same, as also dative and ablative plural, which are actually bellis, like mundis, like, for example, pueris, like viris. But then you see again accusative and vocative, bella, bella, as the nominative. So neuter is quite easy to remember because you should memorize only two things. Genitive, dative, and ablative are the same for all the declension, except, as we saw, for puer and vir. But however, are the same for bellum compared to, for example, lupus or mundus. Instead, direct cases, nominative, accusative, and vocative, are different but are similar, right? Between them, of course, they are the same. In particular, for the singular, we have an ending in -um. For the plural, the ending in -a. Let's go immediately to exercise number one, in which I'll go to the description, of course, of the video if you are not reading to it. In exercise number one, we have to decline templum. Templi as bellum. So, also this time we have to take the stem of the word temple and we should add only the final ending. So, for example, singular nominative templum. So, templum. Genitive templi. Dative templo. accusative templum, vocative templum, ablative templo. Plural, templa, nominativo of course, genitive templorum, dative templis, accusative templa, vocative templa, ablative templis. So as usual, all the nouns, neuter nouns belonging to the second declension have this declension as these final endings. Now, exercise number two instead, we have to translate in all the possible ways, first of all, the word templa. Actually, a ending can be nominative plural, accusative plural, or vocative plural. Of course, templum in Latin means temple. So, templa can be translated as the temples as a subject, the temples as an object, or then as an invocation, o temples. Then we have templo. Templo with ending in o can be dative singular or ablative singular. So we can translate it to the temple, or instead by from the temple, or if we find cum templo with the temple. Then exercise number three, we have of the temples, and we have to translate this expression in Latin actually. And of the temples, so plural, express belongings, right? But it's plural, so genitive plural, we have temple plus the ending of the genitive plural, which is the same for all the nouns of the second declension, never mind the group. So we have templorum. Then we have o temple, which is an invocation, so it's vocative. Temple is singular, so vocative singular is not temple, right, like for example munde o lupe, but it is the same as nominative and accusative singular, because in neuter nouns have the same direct cases for singular and plural. So we have in this situation templum. That's it actually. That was the explanation of the third group of the nouns of the first of the second declension. To sum up what we said in those lessons, remember that all the names belonging to the second declension have e as genitive singular, and then can be divided in three groups. The first group is made by masculine and feminine nouns ending in us, the nominative singular. Second group by masculine nouns ending in er or ir. The only difference between the first and the second group is that in the second group you find the vocative singular not the form e, but you find the same form as the nominative. So puer, nominative, vocative, puer. Vir, nominative, vocative, vir. And instead the neuter, you find the direct cases with the singular ending, for the singular ending in and for the plural instead ending in a. Next time we will try to sum up what we said in these first lessons, in particular by studying the adjective of the first class adjectives. Speak next time.